Hello, good morning to all of you. We are going to study further questions based on dimension analysis in this class. Before that, I request you to subscribe to our YouTube channel and click on the bell icon so that you may receive future notifications. Okay, so we are going to study how to use dimension analysis to convert units. Like we are converting joules into arcs and newton into dynes. We are going to study two questions: how to convert joule into arcs and newton into dynes. Joule is the SI unit of work and arcs is the CGS unit of work. So how many arcs are there in one joule? Okay, so we know that dimension of the work is ML2 T minus 2, M1 L2 T minus 2, and we have to remember the formula regarding conversion of the unit, that N2 is equal to N1 into M1 by M2A into L1 by L2B into T1 by T2C, where A, B, C can be derived from the dimension of the work, and M1 is the first system, i.e. SI system, in which SI system the mass, and M2 is the CGS system of mass. Like you are converting joule into arcs, so you will use M1 in the SI system and M2 in CGS system. So we know that N2 is equal to 1 into 1 kg by 1 gram to power 1. Power 1, why, how is this power 1 is coming? M2 power 1. Then 1 meter by 1 centimeter to power 2, and then 1 second by 1 second to power minus 2. So now the numerator is in kg and denominator is in grams. So convert kg into grams. So 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. Similarly, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and here it is in seconds, both are in seconds, so no need to do anything. So you will get, we need to convert 1 joule into arcs. So N1 will be equal to 1. So we will write N2 is equal to 1 into 1000 gram by 1 gram to power 1. Then we will write 100 centimeter by 1 centimeter to power 2. Then 1 second by 1 second to power minus 2. By solving, we will get N2 is equal to 10 to power 7. So we can come to a conclusion. We can come to a conclusion that 1 joule is equal to 10 to power 7 arcs. Now we will move on to second question. We need to convert newtons into dynes by using dimension analysis. We know that newton is the SI unit of force. SI unit of force. Dimension of the force is M1 L1 T minus 2. Okay. So here we are getting A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, T is equal to minus 2. Then N2 is equal to N1, M1 by M2 A, L1 by L2 B, T1 by T2 C. So N1 is 1, M1 is 1 kilogram, M2 is 1 gram, L1 is 1 meter, L2 is 1 centimeter, and T1 is 1 second, T2 is 1 second. M1, L1, T1 are in MKS, Newton is in MKS, M2, L2, T2 are in CGS, dyne is in CGS. So you need to convert kilograms into grams, 1000 gram by 1 gram, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and 1 second, 1 second, same in both MKS system and CGS system. SI unit of time is second. So you will get 1 into 1000 gram by 1 gram to power 1, 100 by 1 to power 1, 1 second by 1 second to power minus 2. By solving, you will get 10 to power 5. So 1 newton is equal to 10 to power 5 dynes.